everyone, Shannon here for Spellbinders and Fun Stamper's Journey. In this video, we are going to create three cards using the new Buzzworthy Project Kit, and I'm going to share with you some fun and different ways to use colored cardstock to really create some bold and vibrant cards. For our first card, we're going to use a whole bunch of colored cardstocks. I have 11 different shades here, and these are all from Fun Stamper's Journey. I went ahead and trimmed down a 1/4-inch strip from each one of those there, and each strip is 5.5 inches long. But I have a piece of scrap paper here that's a little bit shorter than 5.5. It is 5 3/8, so I just cut off 1/8 from the bottom, and it's about 3 inches wide, but I'm going to use a little bit less than that, but I'd rather have more and just trim off the excess. I went ahead and added some tape all over the front of this scrap of cardstock, and now I'm going to start lining up my strips of cardstock on and sticking them down onto the scrap in rainbow order. I'm taking my time here and making sure I get the very top of each one of these strips lined up perfectly with the top of my scrap panel, and I'm also trying to make sure that each strip is butted up against the previous one so there's no gap, so you can't see any of that cream cardstock between them. And even though I was careful and measured each one of these strips, there's still a little bit of variance between them. So you can see at the bottom, they're a little bit uneven there. And that's why I adhere them onto this panel that's a little bit shorter than 5.5, because I'm going to trim off that little bit at the bottom where it's a little all uneven. But first I'm going to put down some anti-static powder just so I can remove some of the stick that's remaining on this panel or on the scrap panel, and then just trim off that excess. And then I will trim off the tiny little bit at the bottom. And now we have this really beautiful striped piece of paper that we can add to our card front. Now, because I trimmed that panel down, I also have to trim my card base. So this is an A2 white card base that I did trim down 1/8 of an inch off the bottom. So it's actually 4 1/4 by 5 3/8. And I'm just going to add some liquid glue to the back side of my striped panel and adhere it on to my card front. Now I'm going to move on to my image. I have this beautiful stamp set. This is the Block Prints stamp set. This is included in the Buzzworthy kit. And I'm going to use that cute mushroom kind of hexagon shape, and I'm going to place it and stamp it onto this piece of gray cardstock. It is Riverstone, also from Fun Stamper's Journey. You just saw me take out my mouse pad out of my Misti. That is because this Block Print stamp set is a cling stamp set, so you need to remove your mouse pad or your paper pad to compensate for that extra thickness. I went ahead and inked it up in black licorice ink and stamped it. Now I'm going to move on to trimming this image out. I have a pair of long blade scissors. I found these scissors work really well for cutting out this image because of all the straight sides. I just hold the blade parallel with the edge and just trim out, and that will give me a nice straight edge. And I also left a little border of gray here so I didn't cut all the way up to the stamped line. Now I'm going to stamp my sentiment onto my card front. I'm also going to ink it up with black licorice ink, and this sentiment is from the Bold Print stamp set as well. I did stamp it a couple times just to make sure that I got a nice clean, crisp image because I was stamping on all those strips of colored cardstock. Now I'm going to finish my card by adding some foam adhesive to the back side of my image, just a couple strips here. Then I'll remove the backing, and then I will center this and stick it right down, and that will actually complete my card. And as soon as I stick that down, I'll hold it to the camera so you can get a good look. I think you can never go wrong with colorful stripes, and this is a great technique for using up some of your scraps. Let's move on to our second project. I have this awesome hexagon stencil included in the Buzzworthy kit, as well as this lemon drop acrylic paint and journey modeling paste. I'm going to combine the acrylic paint and paste together to create this colored paste, as you can see here on this white cardstock, but we're going to do a little twist here and add it to some color cardstock instead. First thing I'm going to do is scoop out some of this paste and place it down onto my work surface. You don't need a lot. We're not even going to cover the whole card front with this. And once I get some of that paste down onto my work surface, I'm going to move to my acrylic paint and just get a small amount out onto my palette knife. And then I'll start to mix that paint with the paste. And I just kind of scoop it and press it down to kind of really incorporate that acrylic paint. And as you can see here, that little bit went a long way. That paste is already really vibrant yellow, but I am going to add a tiny bit more just to make it a little bit more intense. And once I'm finished mixing that last bit in, I'm ready to add the paste over the stencil and onto my A2 panel of colored cardstock. I'm just going to hold my stencil in place, but you may want to tape yours down just to make sure it doesn't shift on you at all. And this palette knife is also included in the Buzzworthy kit, which is really awesome. It's a great little palette knife, super handy. So I'm not going to spread this everywhere. I'm going to stop and at just that lower right corner. I don't want any of that paste to be there because that's actually where I'm going to stamp my sentiment. And I'm just going to continue to kind of move this around, spread it around so I get kind of an even layer, though I'm not super concerned about it. I just want kind of this to be the background and I want to cover a fair amount of this card front. So there we go. I'm going to just remove that stencil and then I'll set that aside to dry. This does need a fair amount of time to dry. I would give it at least an hour. Even in Arizona, it took about an hour to dry. Now I'm going to move on to my images. I have the Sweet as Honey stamp set here and I pulled off these three bees and I'm going to stamp them onto this scrap of white cardstock. I'm going to ink them up once again in black licorice ink and then stamp them. And then I'm going to move on to doing some very simple coloring. I'm going to use my Copic markers for these. I'm going to start with a really light blue. This is BG10 and just quickly color the very base of the wings. Then I'll move on to a yellow and color the body. That's my light yellow. Now I'm moving on to my medium shade yellow and just color kind of the edges a little bit, but not all the way up to the center. And then a little bit with my darkest color here, which is YR23. And then I'll add a little bit more blue and then I'll move on to my next bee. They're very tiny, so that Copic coloring goes really quick. Now that I have all my bees colored, I'm going to kind of snip them apart and then I'm going to fussy cut them out. I am once again going to leave a little border here. The bigger the border you leave, the easier it is to fussy cut these out. I go fairly close because I really do enjoy fussy cutting and I like to have a nice trim close edge. So I cut pretty close, but again, if you find fussy cutting difficult, you might want to just widen that little white border and that will make it a lot easier so you don't have to really go so tight around those little legs and wings and antenna. So here is my finished bee. I'm going to repeat this process for the other two. And now I'm going to move on to stamping my sentiment. So my panel is completely dry here. It's been actually a little bit over an hour, about an hour and a half. And I'm going to ink up my sentiment and the black licorice ink and stamp that as well. And this sentiment is also from the Sweet as Honey stamp set. Now I'm going to finish this card by adhering the panel onto an A2 top folding white card base. I'm going to just use some liquid glue on the backside of the panel and then I'll just adhere it to my white card base. I could have definitely just made this whole card out of this yellow cardstock, but I'm just trying to be conservative of my colored cardstock here. Now I'm going to add my bees. I added a small amount of foam adhesive to the backside already, so I'm just going to remove the backing and stick them down. And now I'll hold the card up to the camera so you can get a good look. This is a nice, clean, and simple card where you really let the texture of the background shine. And now we're going to move on to our third card. I'm going to grab this flower from the Sweet as Honey stamp set and I'm going to stamp it on to one of my scraps of colored cardstock. After I stamp it in black licorice, I'm going to grab a yellow piece of colored cardstock and stamp it on that one as well. Then I'm going to move on to some green cardstock. I'm going to just stamp the leaf here from the flower onto that cardstock. So I want to make sure all of that leaf, even the very little edge of it where it kind of is overlapped by the flower petals, I want to make sure I get that as well. So I'm going to stamp it once here and then I'm just going to reposition my green cardstock so I can stamp that leaf a second time without having to move my flower around. So I'm just going to ink it up in black licorice and stamp it also. Then I'm going to remove that flower and grab a leaf from the stamp set, just ink that up and stamp that on the green. And now I'm ready to move on to coloring these images in. So I'm gonna do some very simple coloring here. We kind of got a cheat here by using the colored cardstock. That's gonna basically be the base for our flower, and we're going to just add little details with the Copic marker. So I have a kind of a dark Copic marker shade here, and I'm using the kind of flick feathering technique where I kind of start at the base of the petal and kind of flick out, and that just gives this kind of streaky feathered look, and it really is going to make these petals start to pop and look, even though it's just one color, they'll actually look kind of soft even with that one color, like it almost have like a gradation thanks to that kind of feathered flick kind of motion. So I'm going to just quickly color all of the petals here with my Copic marker, and there is the finished result. Now I'm going to move to the very center of the flower. I have a couple colors picked out, or a couple markers picked out. I'm going to start with a yellow. This is just kind of my base, and I'm just going to color that whole center. Now, even though this is pink cardstock, it is a light pink, and we are still getting a bold yellow because we're using a light cardstock. So that's kind of the trick here for when you want to kind of cheat with your coloring and start with a colored cardstock. Pick a lighter shade. You're going to get more range of colors if you pick a lighter shade. So I'm now moving on to my second flower, and I just used an orange and colored this yellow cardstock, or this yellow flower, in with that orange, and now I'm going to move to the center of the flower as well. Here I'm picking kind of a much more mustard brown kind of palette for the center, and once I finish coloring that in, I will move on to the leaves. Now for the leaves, I just have one marker picked out for these. It's a nice dark green. Again, I'm going to do that kind of feathered kind of flick motion with my marker to get that softened edge and almost create a gradation. And once I finish coloring those leaves, I'm going to move on to fussy cutting these images out. I'm going to start by cutting the flower here, and I am going to cut right up to the stamp line. Actually, I'm even going to cut a little bit past the stamp line, so into the stamp line a little bit, just so I can remove as much pink as possible so I don't have any of that pink border. I'm going to work my way around the flower, and when I get to the leaf, I'm going to do it a little bit differently, and I'm going to cut right up to, or right past, I should say, that black line on the leaf. And that's because I'm gonna paper piece the leaf to the flower, and I'm gonna basically completely cover that pink flower, or that pink leaf up. Now I'm gonna move on to taking a black Copic marker and just cleaning up any place that I didn't quite cut all of the pink cardstock off. You definitely don't have to do this, but this does give it a much more polished and clean look. You just go around the edge with that marker and kind of basically cover any of the remaining pink that you have. Now I'm moving on to the leaves. So the leaves here, I'm going to cut off all of the stamped portion of the flower. So anywhere there's a petal, I'm going to cut that off, and I'm actually going to cut all the black off too of that petal. And then when I moved on to the outer edge of the leaf, I'm going to, just like when I cut the flower, cut right up to that stamped line, even into it a little bit to remove as much green as possible. Now I'm ready to kind of piece these together because I have all of my images cut out. Just going to add some liquid glue to the pink flower where the leaf is, and then just glue that leaf on, and repeat that process for my yellow flower as well. And here you can see my finished flowers, and they look so bold and beautiful. You almost wouldn't even believe that I used color cardstock. You would have thought I started with white paper and just colored those. So now I've got my flowers arranged onto a panel of pink cardstock, and I just picked up my sentiment with my Misty and stamped it in black licorice. And now I'm going to move on to finishing this card up. First thing I'm going to do is add some liquid glue to the backside of my panel and adhere it down onto an A2 top folding white card base. Once I have that panel stuck down, I'm going to move on to my flowers. I've already gone ahead and added some foam adhesive to the backside, and I'm just going to position them here on my card front. I kind of play with the set, or the arrangement here, a little bit, kind of moving them back and forth before I fully press down and get those flowers completely stuck. And once I finish sticking down that second flower, I'm going to remove the backing on that little leaf and stick that guy down, and that will actually complete this final card. And I'll hold my card up to the camera so you can get a good look at these flowers. I love the way they turned out. This technique of stamping on colored cardstock and then coloring is such a great way to minimize your coloring and still have bold, beautiful flowers. Here's our second card we created where we made our own tinted paste and applied it onto colored cardstock. I love the contrast here between that light yellow and that mustard yellow. And here's our final card in which we used color cardstock to create a striped background. This is a great technique for using up your color cardstock scraps, and it looks beautiful when it's paired with a bold image like this beautiful mushroom from the Block Prints stamp set. I hope you guys enjoyed today's cards and video. If you'd like any more information on the products I used, please head over to Spellbinders. And thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day.